All right, guys, I am going to try this Amazon coding challenge and see if I do well on it. Let's do it. Maybe I should turn off the camera. Here, I'll turn off the camera. Oh, not this one. This one. You have an array of strings, logins where the lengths of all the strings are equal. A string can be transferred by one divided by rotating strings left, so one A, B, B, C. Two strings, logins are called family logins if one of them can be transferred to another. As an example, strings B, C, D, A, B, C are family logins because each character in B, C, D is above character A, B, C. Okay, so B, C, D, A, B, C. Is one above login? Okay. Find the number of pairs of IJs such which are family logins. Note that any pair of strings can be for a login if the pair of conditions are met. At the array strings bag safe, see if the other pair is like 1 and 3. Okay, bag and CBD. CBH are logins in this. Okay, 1, 2, 3. 1, 4 is a login, 1, 5 is a log. We just need to find the pairs of logins. +1, +2. Bag CBH, that's a login. SFE red, that's a login. Okay. Corn DPSO is a login. E. Okay, so if you. Okay, this is not that hard. I'll just do brute force for now. Are they all the same length? Oh, the lengths are all equal. Okay, so that's good. Okay. Let's just do. We could just subtract each character from each other, like convert the string to ASCII, and then if they're not equal to the previous one, we just say it's not possible, so this would just be false. So, yeah, let's see, convert string to int ASCII. C++. I think it's like minus 0 or something. Why can't I do logins? Yeah, K. Okay, yeah, so we'll just take the first character, subtract it. So let's see, diff is gonna equal to this. And then we just do the same thing. And if this is not equal to the first character, then yeah, then it's just false. Yeah, okay, so this would be 0, this would be 0. And if this is not equal to diff, bool pos equals to true, pos equals to false, break. If pos is true, we're gonna just have a counter and do count plus plus. This should be O of 3. And I think it should work when you run the tests. Might get TLE though, but I have no idea. Output 6, expected 3. Well, let's look at test case 0. Two, three. Can I open another IDE? I think I can. Fuck. Fuck, can't use my IDE. This sucks. Man, that's really sucks. Okay, if I can't use my IDE, I don't know. Let's see what the problem is. Alright, the difference between here is... Oh, it should be absolute value. idea. Corn horn DPSO. I don't need this. Corn horn DPSO DPSO. Should I print? I could just print. If it's possible. Oh, this should be ABS also. Corn horn DPSO EV. Okay, oh, you know what? This sucks. Okay, I have 19 minutes left. What the hell am I doing? We just output the I and the J, where this is. Where it fails. Okay, so 02 works. Why does 02 work? Convert character to ASCII. Let's see, convert. Oh, it's just integer. Okay, let's get rid of this. How is zero still wrong? Zero, two, zero, three, zero, four. What is the problem? Okay, wait. What is the difference? Zero is not equal to one. So it should be, zero is not equal to one. It shouldn't add. Well, let's see. Okay. Pause should be false. This is so dumb. I have 15 minutes. Okay. What is that? What's the next problem? Man, I really don't give a shit about this. This isn't a hard problem, though. Actual diff is 1. Why is our diff 1? Oh, wait. No, wait, that doesn't make sense. Actual, our difference is 0. Actual diff is 1. Yes. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. So if it's... Oh, man, my brain hurts. Okay, so 0, 1. Are these the same? Is... No, no. So we should just break. Okay, so if it's not possible, we just break. I don't think I'll be able to figure this out. Okay, CBU, BAT. Is 1 and 2 true? Oh, it is. Oh, they have to be greater than one. Damn. Let's see, what is the problem? Okay, so if they're not. So only do this if ij is equal to. So, okay. If. Because we shouldn't even do this diff first. Okay, we're getting four of them pass. Man, I only have an hour left. This is fucking ridiculous. I'm gonna only get the first, be able to solve the first one. Coin DPSO, coin EQTP, DPSO, EQTP. Oh, I'm counting twice. Fuck. Okay, we use a set and just add those values into it and then just like return the size of that. In the end, we return occur.size. I think this should work. Maybe it's not this. Okay, hold up. I'm gonna submit it for now. I don't think this one's hard either. Okay. Both of these aren't that hard. I don't know if I have time to just debug this, though. It's just an implementation issue. Let's see if this works. Well, that works. I got more test cases to pass. SDFE, SFE, RED. Basically, the difference of each of the characters must be equal to each other. If they're not, then it should be false. And I think I did that. This minus that. Yeah, this should work. Is it absolute value that's a problem? I'm pretty sure it's not. Does it need to be one, or... A, B, C, A, C, D. Oh, difference has to be greater than zero. Here, if check if our diff is greater than zero, and diff is greater than zero. I have no idea. This is. I could probably debug this since it's in Visual Studio. The problem is that. Fuck it, I'll go to the next problem. I'll go to the next problem. You have n piles of products. The number of products in each pile represents the rate of products. Select a subarray from there. What does that mean? Select a subarray and pick up the products from that subarray such that the number of products you pick from the I sub pile is strictly less than the number of products you pick from the I plus one pile. Oh, okay, so choose a subarray 1, 4, 5, which is 12 products, each of these, and pick products 3, 4, 5. Okay, 1, 2, 3. 2, 3. Seven, four, five. Oh, wait, 3, 4. What? Where did you get 3 from? Choose subarray from indices 1 to 3. So 0, 1, 2, 3. 5, 4, 5, 2. Why would it be 3? I'm going to guess you meant 7 here. Oh, wait, indices 1 to 3. Okay, so 7, 4, 5. So we need to pick products from each of the indices, which, wait. Select a subarray from a number of products and pick up products from that subarray such that the product number of products you pick from the ith pile is strictly less than the number of products you pick from the I plus 1 pile for all indices. So if I pick 1, 3, that's 7, 4, 5. Three, four, five, 5, 2, 6. Smaller than equal to it, right? Wait. I don't understand. What the hell are you talking about? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four. Okay, pick subarray 1 to 3, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, what? 3, 4, 5, what? Why is the maximum of products 12? Oh, 3 plus 4 plus 5. Oh, okay. Similarly, from the we are forced to pick only one product for index 3 as well. Choose subarray index 1 and 1, pick all 7 products. What is the size of the subarray? What do they want? Fuck, man, I can't do this. Choose subarray from 1, 1, pick all 7 products. I don't actually understand. One, two. Oh. Okay, I think I understand what they mean. Okay. Can I code this? In time, though? Okay. Two, three, four, five, two. Well, I have enough time. Fuck. Okay. Choose subarray indexes 1 to 2 from. And pick products 2 and 9 respectively from each index, which is 11. Okay. I think I'll. I could brute force this. Okay, we just have to check if products at j is greater than I plus one, products at j minus one, I plus one, then we just add by. Yeah, so if products oh yeah, so products minus products at j minus one is greater than equal to is greater than one. J minus one plus one. Right? Yeah. So 9 minus 2, 7. We can't do that, so we just do 3. 2 plus 3 plus 4. Yeah. I don't think we could just create another array, so we could just do like. Reset, I don't know. if products at I is greater than or equal, fuck, this test case doesn't work. Choose array indices 1 if I pick products 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is 15. Fuck. Pick products 2, 3, 4, 7, which is 16 products. One, two, three, four, five. So there would be 2 many edge cases. One, two, three, four, and five. Two plus three plus four plus five. What is that? Two plus two plus four plus five. One plus two plus three plus four plus five is 15. In what scenario would this not work? Let's say you had 2 and 9. Maximum, this would be like maximum sum of subarray or something. idea. Let's just... Okay, let's just try... Increasing subarray sum, maximum increasing subarray sum. I should be able to figure out the first one, though. B, C, A, H. This debugging actually sucks. If it's not equal to the first one, oh, we could also have a previous difference. Still no. I don't know. Wait, do they have to be only one? Oh, they have to be one. Wait. Okay, so we don't need previous diff. Still no. Oh, what the fuck? Okay, I think that didn't do anything. I got less now. bag, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. When they say family, what do they mean by that? One step, one time, but rotating his characters right by one step. Oh! Oh my god. Z has to go back to A. Oh man, that's so fucking dumb. Man, that's really dumb. Okay, so if it was Z... I have to mod it by like 26 or something. I think. It's still not working. I honestly don't know. Pretty sure you have to mod it then. Oh, man. I feel like this is not a hard problem. I just don't want to debug. Or I just can't. Oh, wait. I don't have to do all the subtraction. Wait, fuck it. Okay, I'll rewrite everything. Actually, yeah, I think I'll just rewrite everything. Fuck. There's 20 minutes left. Let's try something real quick. This would be so much easier in Visual Studio. My god. It's like plus 97. Cast this into an integer. Oh my god, okay, how do I add? Convert character to ASCII. Oh my god, okay, what is this? For at ASCII and C++ ASCII table. Okay, we have A, which is 97. Oh, would it just be this one plus one? DPSO? BCD? Yeah. And then we have to mod it by, who is Z, it would be. Something like that. Else this. Now we just have to count how many strings or the same as this. I have 18 minutes left. Fuck. Okay, so this is. Corn DPSO. 3 would be EQTP. What the fuck? That was it? Oh, now this is easy. Count plus equal counts at V. Yay! Holy shit! That was fucking amazing. Man, I solved the first one. All right, this one, this is going to, I don't know if I could solve the second one in 15 minutes. I could try. In my opinion, it might just be like, the bucket too. Oh, wait. Nope. It's probably okay. This is probably a 2-point right click is disabled. I don't think this problem is that hard. I just don't. Okay, if it was like. Two plus three plus four. Would it be two plus three plus four? No, it would be one plus two. Yeah, one, two plus three plus four. Two plus four plus five. No, three plus four plus, what the fuck? Three plus four plus five. Wait, isn't that just taking seven plus five though? Godly, this is hard. I'm not gonna, okay, this is not hard to do. I can't debug this in time. Oh, wait. I is four. Four, I could do 2 plus 2 plus 4. No, 3 plus 4, 5. Loop from J minus 1 down to 0. J plus equal to I, whatever. No, but that wouldn't work because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This would be 1 plus 2 plus 6. Yeah, that wouldn't work either. Whatever. Man. Okay, I could definitely figure this out. I just didn't have time. I think you just have to use sliding window. Like, if this plus that, if it's greater, do 4 plus 3 plus 2. J minus I 3 times... Two times three, no. Wait, no. Would that work? I don't know. Okay. Whatever. I have 8 minutes left. I'll just submit this. I could definitely figure out this part. Wait, I might be able to figure it out. Three plus four. Three plus four plus five. Okay, let's see if we can do this really fast. Yeah, it's too late. Fuck it. It's too late. I don't think I'll be able to answer it. Alright, well, this is a good challenge. Hope you guys enjoy this video. I'll just submit it. Wake up, subscribe. I'll check you guys later. Please.